Frogs play a very important part in nature. For example, frogs control the population of certain animal species. They create useful chemicals that humans cannot utilize, and they are also prime indicators on how healthy the environment is. However, frog numbers are decreasing and human intervention is the number one cause. To understand the problem and the solution, we asked a specialist to inform us more on what frogs really are.
They start out, they go through a process called metamorphosis. And in this process, they start out as tadpoles. Tadpoles are small circular creatures that have tails and gills, and they live in the water. Tadpoles usually feast off of algae or plants or any other decaying organic matter. This is the first stage that frogs go through in their development process. After a couple of weeks, or sometimes months, depending on the species of frog or toad, these tadpoles grow into frogs or toads. They lose their tails, and they lose their gills, and they grow, they get legs and lungs, and they start breathing air and living on land. Now, frogs feed off of either, usually insects, sometimes bigger frogs can feast off of small creatures, like small mice that live in their habitat. Frogs generally live in swampy or like watery areas, so either swamps or rainforests or lakes, near lakes, and this is where they found most of their food.
Turtle frogs are carnivores, feeds on worms, beetles, flies, and other insects. The prey is swallowed by picking off the ground or vegetation.
Frogs are either diurnal or nocturnal. Nocturnal frogs, which most species are, search for their food in the morning and rest at night. Nocturnal frogs have a dark skin or spotted skin that helps them stay camouflaged in the dark and helps them avoid predators. Diurnal frogs hunt for their prey during the morning and rest at night, similar to humans. Diurnal frogs tend to have their skin with eccentric colors to forewarn predators about their poisonous skin.
We know the fact that they croak at night, which is a signal to choose their mates. Frogs tend to be nocturnal because night is the best time for them to catch prey such as insects, worms, flies. They are different in colors, which keep them hidden from predators as they sleep during the day.
As mentioned before, frogs are very important in relation to the environment and humans as well. Frogs have many benefits such as naturally secreting chemicals that humans can use for medicine and other utilities. For example, certain chemicals can be used to help treat heart problems or can be used as medical glue. Frogs are also a very interesting topic for scientific research. For instance, some frogs seem to stop aging after reaching maturity or have the ability to hibernate over years on end. And finally, frogs are a prime indicator in informing us on the health of the environment. However, frog numbers are diminishing. Nocturnal frogs have a problem. Since they hunt at night and they require the darkness to keep safe, having artificial light that humans produce can be a big hindrance to the frog's daily cycle.
Pollution, as it is occurring due to industrialization, it has affected the lives of frogs and their survival. All the activities that occur during night are affected by light. Thus, they have impact on metamorphosis. They keep themselves hidden, which affect their calling for mates. They cannot go for hunting when there is excessive amount of light. Moreover, the light affects DNA synthesis and creation of hormones in frogs. Light can temporarily blind them as well. For saving their existence, it is very important to encourage their protection. It can make people aware of light pollution, as well as make people strive to protect it. More research on this area can help spread awareness and help the public understand what's actually happening on the earth. The easy solution is use less light.
Some other things we can do are using light that are more yellow or red. Scientists conducted an experiment where frogs had to choose to go towards two different colors of light. Frogs in the experiment chose the light that was closer to the spectrum, closest to violet. Research has also shown that the brighter the light, the more attractive the frogs are. Thusly, dimming the lights or using not as bright lights would be more beneficial to the frogs. Finally, having the lights automatically switch off when the sun goes down and using blinds to keep the light from inside the houses in will help make sure that frogs aren't so heavily affected. Frogs, as mentioned before, play an important part in our ecosystem. They help support humans and the environment in a variety of ways, and so protecting them and letting them help us is an important duty we should all try and uphold.